evolving a system of classification for scalp defects and methods of reconstruction. And the speaker will be Dr. U. Rashida Begum. She has done her MCH plastic surgery from 2008 to 2011 from Madras Medical College. She is right now assistant professor in the Department of Plastic and Reconstructive Surgery at the Rajiv Gandhi Government General Hospital and Madras Medical College, Chennai, and consultant at Desire Aesthetics, Chennai. Her fields of interest are breast reconstruction, hand surgery, microvascular, microneural surgery, aesthetic surgery, and lasers. And moderating this session would be Dr. Nirmala Ponnambalam, a consultant plastic surgeon, and she has the experience, wonderful experience of being the HOD in the Department of Burns, Plastic and Reconstructive Surgery at the Government Kilpok Medical College and Hospital, Chennai. Good evening, madam. And I shall now hand over this session to Dr. Nirmala Ponnambalam.
Good evening, Karthikeyan. Can you hear me?
Yes, madam, we can hear you.
Where is Rashida? I can't see her anywhere on the screen. Rashida?
Yes, ma'am.
Now I can hear you. Good. I think we'll start with the session straight away, Karthikeyan, if you don't mind.
Madam, please go ahead.
I think, Rashida, you can start it. You can start speaking, Rashida, about your
presentation. Yes. Good evening, madam.
Good evening, Rashida.
Can we have your video, madam? Rashida, madam.
Video.
Yes, you're on.
Now I can see you, Rashida.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, madam. Good evening, all. Thank you, sir. Today, my topic is on evolving a system of classification for scalp defects and methods of reconstruction. Before going to the main topic, I want to tell you a salient features in surgical anatomy of the scalp. Scalp starts from anteriorly supraorbital margin to superior nuchal line posteriorly. Laterally, a line drawns through the frontal process of the zygoma across the zygomatic arch to the mastoid prominence. Forehead and scalp is considered as a single unit. Scalp has five layers like skin, subcutaneous tissue, galea aponeurotica, loose areolar tissue, and pericranium. We are usually raising the flap in the subgaleal plane. Scalp has a rich vascular supply. It has five dominant vessels, namely supratrochlear and supraorbital artery from the internal carotid artery, superficial temporal posterior auricular artery and occipital artery from the external carotid artery. It has highly interconnected in the region of the vertex. Because of high interconnection at the region of the vertex, that permits a retrograde flap elevation in the scalp, and microvascular replantation of the entire scalp will survive on single artery and vein anastomosis. The causes of the scalp defects are broadly classified into congenital and acquired. The congenital causes are aplasia cutis congenita. It may be partial or full thickness defect. Acquired causes are trauma, burns, infection, and neoplasms. The factors used to assess the evaluation of the scalp defects are size, site, depth of the wound, laxity of the surrounding skin of the scalp, nature of the available tissue, patient's factor, age, and comorbid illness. Coming to the classification, we are classifying the scalp defects based on the width of the defect. Less than 3 cm, it is considered as a small. 3 to 6 cm is moderate defect. 6 to 9 cm, it's large defect. More than 9 cm, it's considered as an extensive defect of the scalp. The goal of reconstruction is, number one, restore the scalp with a durable cover. Number two is to provide hair bearing skin as much as possible and give the good aesthetic outcome. We are usually following the reconstructive ladder. I want to show the few clinical pictures and advantages and disadvantages of the each steps in the reconstructive ladder. I will start from conservative management. Superficial well-vascularized wound of the scalp will heal spontaneously. This is a picture of aplasia cutis congenita that was healed completely with the plain saline dressing. This is a late post-operative picture of the patient after 3 months. The primary closure of the scalp wound is possible if the scalp wound width is less than 3 cm width along with the smooth elastic tissue on the surrounding area. This can be done by extensive scoring of the adjacent tissues or by doing the gallial scoring. Coming to the next is split skin grafting. Large defects with the vascularized bed will accept the split skin graft because of extensive vascularity of the scalp. It is easier to do. The major disadvantage of SSG is it is cosmetically inferior. It gives graft alopecia in the site and it gives the unstable scar, especially in the dependent site. This is the case of post-traumatic soft tissue defect of the scalp after debridement. I did SSG for this case. This is the 6 months late post-operative picture with the well-settled scar. And coming to the main topic in the ladder is local flaps. It is moderate and large defects exposing the cranial bone without pericranium. It may be rotation flap or transposition flap. Rotation flap may be single or double. Transposition flap may be single or double. It is depends upon the size of the defect. This is the case of post-traumatic soft tissue defect in the frontal region. I did the rotation flap for that. The second picture shows the gallial scoring for the advancement of the flap. This is the late post-operative picture after 2 months. The marking of the flap of rotation flap should be within the hairline to avoid to give good aesthesis to avoid the suture line exposure. In the main advantage of the rotation flap is no donor site alopecia. This is the second case of post-traumatic soft tissue defect in the frontal region. Debridement and frontal rotation flap was done. This is a case of skin adenexal tumor in the parietal region. Excision and rotation flap was done. I want to show this picture to show the retrograde flow of the scalp flap, because the retrograde flow also possible in the scalp defect because of extensive interconnection in the vertex region. This is a case of electrical burn wound in the parietal region. Debridement and flap cover, rotation flap cover was done. This is a case of SCC in the parietal region. Wide local excision was done. It was covered by double rotation. This is called this 0-2-Z-plasty. The post-surgical wound shows the zero, like O. Its closure is shows the suture line is like Z. This is called as O-2-Z-plasty, or otherwise called as double rotation of the scalp. This is the post electrical burn soft tissue defect in the vertex region. I did rotation and advancement flap for this case. Rotation flap from the front region and advancement of the occipital region. This is the late post operative picture. I want to tell some key factors regarding rotation flap in the question and answer manner. Why to choose rotation flap? Because it gives beautiful hair-bearing skin cover, no secondary defect, tension distributed over the long suture line, and re-rotation is possible. These are all the advantage of the rotation flap. Next is, what is the disadvantage of rotation flap? Large flap is needed for the smaller defects. When to choose the rotation flap? When the scalp defect width is 3 to 6 cm width. How to facilitate the mobilization? Wide undermining of the surrounding tissue and gallial scoring and back cut if you want. next in the local fluff is transposition fluff. This is a case of post electrical burn soft tissue defect in the left temporal region. Wound debridement and transposition fluff was done. I want to show the two pictures in the occipital region. The first row of pictures was, it is a post electrical burn defect in the occipital region, wound debridement. I did the transposition fluff from the right side of the scalp. Lower one is this adnexal tumor of the skin, wide local excision and transposition fluff was done from the left side region. The main disadvantage of a transposition fluff is it gives donor site morbidity. Donor site was covered with the SSG and long dog ear. This is a case of electrical burn in the frontoparietal region, debridement and double transposition was done. One is from the anterior, another one is from the posterior. What is the key factors in decision making in the transposition fluff? Why to choose transposition fluff? Number one is they have greatest margin of safety. Number two is it gives tension free closure. How much can we go for transposition fluff? Safely we go up to 1:3 ratio if you add the named vessels in the base of the fluff. Want to know a tip out of routine planning? Yes. That is, design the fluff to avoid the donor site graft at the dependent area, especially in the occipital region, thereby to prevent the pressure over the grafted site in lying portion. What to avoid? Avoid dog ear excision in the same sitting in case of transposition fluff, because if you do the dog ear excision at the same sitting, it will jeopardize the vascularity of the fluff. Coming to the next defect is the post-surgical, post-traumatic soft tissue defect in the vertex region closed by the articochia flap. It is otherwise called as a banana peel flap. This is the three flaps based on the three different vessels. This is very useful for the vertex or central defects closure. The 30% of the cranial wound defects can be closed by this technique. Bipedical flap also possible in the scalp region. It can be harvested like anteroposterior direction or right to left direction. It is indicated mainly in the elliptical defects of the scalp. The main disadvantage is a donor site alopecia. This can be removed by serial excision or by tissue expansion. I want to show the few important points in the Gallia scoring. The Gallia scoring is very much useful in case of a primary closure of the wound, scalp wound, and also advancement of the flap. The scoring should be done 1 centimeter apart. Each scoring gives 1 millimeter advancement only. Take care not to injure the underlying vessels. Scoring should be perpendicular to the advancement of the flap. If you want to move the flap in the vertical direction, you should do the Gallia scoring in the horizontal direction. Scoring should be done under the loop magnification, thereby to avoid the underlying vasculature. This is a few clinical pictures of Gallia scoring. Coming to the next topic is distant flaps. Indication for the distant flap is extensive defect with the unavailable local tissues. The trapezius flap and the latissimus dorsi flap is mostly used for the coverage of the scalp wound. This is a case of post-electrical burn soft tissue defect in the forehead, temporal and zygomatic region. Wound was debrided and supraclavicular flap was done. And after division of the wound and thinning was done, the last picture shows the late postoperative picture of the patient. This is a case of post-surgical soft tissue defect in the occipital region, exposing the occiput without pericranium. We did a vertical trapezius flap cover. Coming to the next topic is free flap. Indication for the free flap is large to extensive defect with the unavailable local tissues. If the scalp wound is more than 9 centimeter defect exposing the cranium, go for free flap. Commonly used free flaps in the scalp defect coverage is mainly fasciocutaneous flap, anterolateral thigh flap, the muscle flap, latissimus dorsi flap, and large omental flap also used for the coverage of the scalp wound. But it has some disadvantages. That is, it becomes thin over time and it looks nodular because of the omental fat, and it is not suitable for long term durable cover. I want to show the few clinical photographs. This is a case of congenital nevus in the forehead. Excision and ALT flap cover was done. This last two pictures shows after thinning. This is a case of scalp avulsion injury. Entire scalp was covered by free latissimus dorsi muscle with the SST. The third picture shows the well settled flap and graft. This is the same patient with the hairpiece. Coming to the next important topic is secondary procedures in the scalp. I want to tell the secondary procedure. One is scar revision and second one is a tissue expansion. This is a case of a post-surgical scar in the frontal and parietal and vertex region. This can be excised and primarily closed. How to reduce the suture line scar alopecia? By one, first, the incision line should be parallel to the hair follicles, thereby to avoid the injury to the root of the hair follicle, thereby reducing the scar alopecia in the suture line. Second one is by doing the trichophytic closure. Coming to the next topic in the secondary procedure is tissue expansion. This is a case of post-burn scar alopecia in the frontal and the temporal region that was covered with the tissue expansion. It gives beautiful hair-bearing skin. The tissue expansion gives us so many advantages. The main advantage of the tissue expansion is it gives beautiful hair-bearing skin to resurface the scalp. And disadvantage is this is a two-stage procedure, longer duration. Complication is hematoma, implant exposure, infection, and flap necrosis. The tissue expansion is ideal for large scalp defects because number one, the skull acts as a rigid base for the expander. Number two is scalp skin is thicker, thereby reducing the risk of extrusion of the tissue expander. And third is because of rich vascularity of the scalp, it reduces the risk of infection. This is the simple algorithm of reconstruction of scalp defect. If the scalp defect is less than 3 cm, the surrounding skin is smooth and elastic, go for primary closure. If the scalp defect is 3 to 6 cm covering the pericranium, go for SSG. If it is not covering with the pericranium, go for rotation flap. If the wound is 6 to 9 cm exposing the cranium without pericranium, go for transposition flap. If the wound is extensive, more than 9 cm, the absence of pericranium, go for distant flap or free flap. To conclude, for successful reconstruction of the scalp defects, number one is knowledge of simple algorithm is must, and good planning and adequate debridement of the wound and proper execution, at last but not least, is proper postoperative care. It is no matter lower or higher, we are in the ladder of reconstruction. Emergence of perfect and awesome results start from we drench ourselves in the joy of blending art, science, skill at every step in our surgeries. My immense thanks to all my teachers who taught, guided, and supported me for what I am today. I feel happy to walk in their path and seek all their blessings and support throughout my journey. Thank you all for patient listening. I thank all the professors and colleagues and PGs in KMC as well as in MMC. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Rashida.
Thank you, madam.
Succinct, you know, you have been very clear ideas right in a short time. It's a very, very well presented theme.
Madam, now, one minute. Dr. Rashida, can you stop sharing your screen?
Yes, sir.
Please, thank you. Yes, madam, you can go ahead.
Rashida, I think I'll sum up.
Yes,
you know, for the
yes, ma'am.
Karthikeyan, can I share the screen? I put some slides, yes, so that. Yes, the slides instead. Shall I?
Yes, madam, please.
I started sharing. Are you getting it now? No. Yes? Can you see it now?
Yes, madam.
Your algorithm was very good. I'll start with the slideshow. I think that'll be better. Now it's, So you did mention about the soft tissue. So sometimes these defects, you know, they can be very deceptive, especially in electrical burns. So always have in mind that you can have a CSF leak, a damage to the dura or a calvarium. You know, sometimes on the table you have seen that you just knock it, the wall of the outer table comes off. So be prepared for all that. Sometimes when you have this dura and calvarium defects, you can always team up with a neurosurgeon, which is mutually beneficial. So you can add that in the algorithm. Otherwise, soft tissue algorithm is very good to remember. You know, they usually say small, medium, or large defect. You have put in nice compartments. So why it's unique scalp is because you have to replace like with like. You cannot get a tissue like the scalp with the hair bearing the skin. As you said, primary closure, very good. For the postgraduate's sake, make the defect elliptical. Always go in for that 3:1 ratio. And have a layered closure, you know, different layers, galea and everything. This prevents tension, for one. And another, the scar alopecia can be prevented. And you can have, even the depressed scar can be prevented. So you can undermine very well, you know, and prevent the tension. Then for the SSG, which is our workhorse, because we are coming from a burn center, that has been our first preference. We always cover first, because when you cover, the raw area is closed and you can always expand later whenever it's feasible. And about the local flaps, please learn your biogeometry. You've got to have them at the tip of your fingers because you will be having your dermatological colleagues referring these patients to you. So you have to give a good result. And as Rashida said, in a transposition flap, you put a graft in a less cosmetically sensitive. In English, I think it means that you can cover it up with hair. And some points, remember, do not distort the frontal hairline, the sideburns. And sometimes enthusiasm can even pull up the pinna when you undermine and the eyebrows. Always keep in mind the direction of hair follicle. Rashida has pinpointed that. And another point, in the vertex, the hair is involved. So try to maintain that orthicochia flap. Always include a vascular pedicle that makes your flap sturdier. And learn to innovate. I could not resist putting the step flap because it sort of brings out what Karthikeyan has in mind. See, we always defect, you know, you make into a circular defect or a triangularized. And in this case, it's nicely squared, you know, and it gives a good result in the vertex. And in rhomboid, you can turn the rhomboid flap. And some flaps, double hatchet flaps, going for something new, you know, keep innovating, keep learning. And the rotational flap, you have to be very careful because sometimes you don't get the 5 times of the rotation. The scalp might be limited scalp skin. So you can go in for a triple or a rotation flap. There's one small modification, I learned snail rotation flap. Go into YouTube, it's postgraduates, you can see a very nice chain. We are from the X to 2X in the radius, and then a slight rotation at the tip makes like a look like a snail, but the end result is very good. And pinwheel, I think you read about it. And rhomboid flap, especially the temporal and parietal defects, because without altering the sideburns, so you have to know which limb has to be brought together. Galear scoring, I brought this out because it's very important. You have given all the points, Rashida, perpendicular to the direction of movement. Give 1 centimeter gap between the incisions and take care of subgal vascularity. And somewhere I read it gives 1.67 millimeter per incision movement. And about the dog ears, as you said, let them be, do not disturb them. They will settle. And if they do not, you can always correct it later on if you need to. Some recent advances, you have showed the first case of secondary healing. They are used back in certain places, but not much of pressure because it should not disrupt the neovascularization or the peripheral blood supply. So maintain a 10 to 25 millimeter of mercury. And some people use this dermal regeneration templates. It's quite expensive. And they use this component separation. This is the words I want to please remember because I think they might be used quite frequently. And delaminate them. That is, you can either have a galleal flap or an osteogalleal flap or the temporary parietal fascia flap. So I'll come out of the sharing. Now the chat, if you have any questions, Rashida, you read out the questions and answer them. It's a ball is in your court now, please.
What is your take on burr hole for exposed bone? I didn't do a single case for burr hole in any case.
Can I take this question, yes, Rashida?
Yes, ma'am.
This one question. We have done burr holing in burns. What you have seen, I think you might have seen. Make multiple burr holes and wait for the granulation tissue to peep out. And once they cover, then cover the skin grafting when the pericardium is not available. Next question.
In case if we do decortication, should you go for SSG immediately or will you do it after few days? Do it for immediately. In case if you do decortication, should you go for SSG immediately or will you do it after a few days? After decortication, do immediately. Cover should be immediate.
Okay.
Do you use tumescent? No, I didn't use tumescent. Tell me your procedure for scale with bony defects. Tell me your procedure for scale.
It must mean
depends defects. Upon the size, no, ma'am?
I think it
I showed in the algorithm, no?
No, bony defects. She wants to know about
bony defects. I didn't mention anything about the bone defects.
Yeah, but you can tell her that you can use the same bone or a rib or you can use a
titanium plate. Are metpore implants also available, ma'am, for cranial defects? That's it, ma'am.
Okay. Can you say something about the... I think they didn't ask those questions, but about something aversion, about scalp aversion, have you faced any case? Have you done any?
Yes, ma'am. Scalp aversion.
Yeah.
No, madam. I don't have any experience in scalp aversion.
Karthikeyan, can you tell me something about scalp aversion?
Yes, but we have done a replantation of scalp and sometimes we have tried to harvest the skin graft from the owl scalp if you're not able to replant it and put it as a skin graft. But generally when you're doing a replantation, the biggest problem that you have is, the first problem that we have is the hair, taking off the hair from the owl scalp is a big problem because whenever we shave it, immediately when it falls, it sticks to the underlying fascia. So I think from Ganga Hospital, there was a paper in which they talked about inverting it over a kidney tray and then shaving it, putting it over a kidney tray to prevent the hair from sticking to the... And otherwise, as Dr. Rashida was talking about the blood supply, there are so many blood vessels. Arterializing just a single arterial anastomosis or one or two veins is enough to vascularize the entire scalp. I think that is what we have done. And there is one more question from Dr. Ganapathy Krishnan, to comment about tumescents.
I don't use tumescents, sir.
No.
But he has given a comment saying that you can inject tumescents. You can take a
point. Yes, sir. Can be injected.
Yeah, that's what he says. What about this
gallial flap seems tricky. I have seen
some. Yeah, that is only to mention for the post graduates. Even I have not done any gallial flap, Umar. Umar, you are from? Where are you?
The gallial flap is usually done for the temporal defects, madam. It is raised.
I would like to see your video. You've been coming for every...
Yeah. Hello?
The gallial flaps can be raised.
Yeah. Okay. What is your take on that, Umar?
Hello?
You said something, this gallial flap is tricky.
Yeah. Whenever we take gallial flap, hello?
Yes, sir.
It seems very tricky. Sometimes it takes very well and the graft we put on that takes very well. But sometimes I could not explain what happens. Sometimes it doesn't take. That's why I asked the question. It seems something is there in taking the flap, something tricky. Sometimes, most of the times it takes. But sometimes it is such that on the table, in the graft, your flap is very good, but on third or fourth day, when you see the graft is not sticking and the bone underneath gets exposed, That's why I asked the madam, anything special about taking the gallial flap? Because we have many animal injuries here, wild animal injuries, bear mauls. We have a lot experience of taking the gallial flaps on the scalp. That's why I posed this question, anything special about taking these flaps? That was my
point. We have not done
point.
If somebody was done it in the forum, they can come out with their experience.
See, most of the time, these gallial flaps are done by the neurosurgeons to line the cranial cavity when they have done a bicoronal, it is for the craniofacial surgeries, they use it to line the cranial cavity. But we per se have never done only as a gallial flap to shift it the royal.
Yes, ma'am. Mostly we take in the trauma only. For the X1, there are big defects on the scalp. We take for that and put a graft straight on that. Plus the other measures like the gallial scoring, transposition flaps and all that. When there is not paucity of the tissues and we have to cover a lot, we take the gallial flap, then this skin flap for the other defect side by. We take for that.
Can I add a comment? Can I add a comment?
There's one more question. Parashida, skin surface for smaller defect.
Yes.
You can answer. Yes, Vishnu Babu wants to know if we can use skin substitute for smaller defects.
Integra can be used, madam.
Yeah, and that's what I was talking about. It's called I didn't want to use that name, so I used the terminology. Something like dermal regeneration.
Can I make a comment?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now, you also spoke about the use of microvascular free flaps for scalp reconstruction,
yes,
especially
yes.
when the defects are large.
Yes.
I don't know. I have come. The biggest problem in using free flaps for the scalp is the fixation of the entire flap. Because, for instance, usually you can use an anterolateral flap or a free latissimus dorsi muscle flap, which gives you a large area to cover the large defect. But the whole problem is, I feel when you are shifting the patient, when they are holding the head, it can shear off very easily. I don't know if the others in the forum have come across this problem and how they overcome this problem. This is, I think it's a quite big problem, issue of shearing the flap and shifting the patient.
Yeah, you really need to take care and you need to tell the nursing staff and the relative to take care because patient, till he comes out of anesthesia, I think there's a relative in the nursing staff and the doctors need to take care that there is no shearing of that. And how sometimes you may have to keep patient in a lateral position or in a prone position. It is a tasking thing when you are from the anterior on the vertex. That's the main issue when you are covering the vertex. I know it is not
easy. I want to
add
here. Hello, I want to add here, mostly we keep all the parts of the, when we dress the patient, when we take free flap or anything, when pedicle flap for the skull, we keep an adhesive marking there, marked as a pedicle, don't touch this side, don't put it on the depending position like that. And always, whenever the patient is to be shifted, we make it a point that it is to be shifted by a resident doctor. And also the advice is to the sisters and nursing staff also, that patient should not lie on that side. You have to eat that. And whenever the position is to be changed in the initial days, it is always to be done by the on the duty. We make it a point, especially while shifting, because the patient is not fully conscious at the time after the extubation. That time it is to be make it a point that he is very meticulously taken to shift to the trolley as well as to the bed in the post-operative ward.
One point I wanted to make was whenever you're doing a transposition for a bare bone, so you need to take your transposition graft slightly larger than the bare bone defect, because once you, if you take exactly and then we're shifting it, you may have the some part of the bone which stays bare after you raise the thing. So if you overlap that, the graft take is much better. Some part of the flap should overlap your donor area of the flap only.
Right.
Otherwise, that junction exactly, then you will.
And you always fall short at the point where it is most needed. at a little yes. most part.
Yeah, that's why planning.
Short there only.
Yeah, that's why planning in reverse never goes.
Yeah,
away.
Ma'am. Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Yeah, yeah, ma'am. Absolutely.
I think Kartikeyan, it is a very good initiative which you have started. Very well done. Very thoughtful.
Very nice. Very nice.
Yeah. Very nice.
It was very nice to see. Thank you, madam. It was very nice to see two youngsters who are totally different. As I said, two different ends of the reconstructive ladder. One person talking about the local flaps mainly, and the other person talking about the free flaps. And each is so unique. And I think both of them had a very good collection of cases.
Yes.
They are very neatly presented. I think both of them, and this is the aim of this program, madam, to introduce the speakers and to have seniors like you, stars already, stars like you to introduce them and guide them. And I think Dr. Nirmala Ponnambalam is back. Madam, you are muted, madam. The mic is muted. Yes, madam, you're on.
I had a very good session. Like, it was nice meeting Prabha Yadav after a long time, you know. Last time, I don't know when I met you, maybe in Nabicon or somewhere, I don't know, maybe 6 months or so. And Selva, beautiful presentation. And the outcome was so good. And Rashida, where is she? I mean, I miss her on the screen.
She's there.
Very good presentation, Rashida. All your
thank you, ma'am.
Graphs, you know, very well done.
Yes, very, very good presentation.
Kartikeyan.
Yes. Thank you, madam.
It's nice to see them doing so well.
Yes, exactly. Right. Now, yes. Can we, it was a great presentation. And I would like to thank the speakers, Dr. Rashida and Dr. Selva Sitaraman. As yes. I said, fantastic cases and excellent presentation. I think they need a good hand.
Yeah,
thank you, sir.
And of course, the moderation done by Dr. Prabha Yadav and Dr. Nirmala Ponnambalam, you have added to the presentations. I mean, we thought they were rich enough. You have made it even further rich with your experiences. Thank you both very much, madam, for your time and your patience in guiding the youngsters. And so with the happiness that we have found two new stars, they were already stars. We have just introduced them to a bigger audience today.
Yes.
And thank you very much, madam. And before I close, I just want to give a glimpse of what we're going to see next week. So next week, we'll be having, do not miss the episode on 1st September. Tuesday, 6 p.m. onwards. There are two sessions as usual. The first session will be Dr. Sasikumar Dakshinamurthy, who will be talking on rhinoplasty, the use of rib grafts, and the moderator will be Dr. Kapil Agrawal from Mumbai. And the second session will be Dr. V.S. Valarmadi, who will be talking on lessons learned in the management of vascular anomalies, and the moderator will be Dr. Ashish Gupta from CMC Vellore. So looking forward to seeing you there with the same motto of to learn, to contribute, and to encourage. And thank you, Dr. Selva Sitaraman, Dr. Rashida, Dr. Prabha Yadav, madam, and Dr. Nirmala Ponnambalam, madam. Thank you.